Hi, I'm Cynthia, and I'll briefly be going over the ERP portion of the Autism Phenome Project. The ERP takes place at the UC Davis Center for Mind and Brain, located in Davis. When you arrive at the Center for Mind and Brain, you'll want to take the elevator up to the second floor. As you exit the elevator, turn to your right and head to the Center for Mind and Brain Annex. Pick up the phone and use the directions to contact the ERP office. Someone will come to the door to greet you and let you in. You'll be led to a room in order to get everything set up. Your child can pick out a movie to watch, have a snack, or play with toys while the investigator describes what the plan is for the day. For this session, your child will be fitted with a special cap. First, the investigator will measure your child's head and then choose the best fitting cap. The cap looks a lot like a shower cap with sensors that resemble lifesavers and wires attached to it. The cap has two chin straps and an elastic Velcro belt that goes around the chest to secure it in place. These will be adjusted once the cap is on. Once the cap is properly adjusted, the ERP team members will use a Q-tip and a bit of rubbing alcohol to move the hair aside at each sensor to ensure a good electrical signal from your child's brain. We want to assure you that there is no danger or pain at all involved with recording electrical activity from the brain using this method. All we're doing is measuring the very subtle electrical current coming from your child's scalp that is always present. No electricity will be going to your child. After this step is done, the team members will apply a small amount of non-irritating gel at each sensor in the cap to help ensure a good connection at each site. Once everything is working correctly, you and your child will walk down the hall to the testing room. In the testing room is a special quiet room where you and your child will watch a movie and hear some sounds. On the computer screen, each connection is displayed. More gel will be applied to the sensors if needed. Ideally, we want each site to be as close to blue as possible, ensuring good connectivity. Please be aware that this can take a few minutes. During this time, your child can have a snack, play with a special toy, or begin watching a movie. Then it's time to listen to some sounds. A set of headphones will be placed over your child's ears for the experiment. During the session, your child will hear a series of tones at different sound levels, none of which are very loud. A member of the ERP team will stay with you and your child while the other members of the ERP team and any other family members can observe on monitors outside the quiet room. During the session, your child should remain seated on your lap and fairly still. Some parents have found it helpful to have a favorite movie to watch during the session. Sessions vary in length and are somewhat dependent on how still your child remains. If your child does get a little restless and needs to move, we can pause the recording to take a short break or have a snack, and then continue. Outside, researchers will be videotaping the session and collecting data on how your child's brain responds to the sounds he or she is hearing. Although your child will not have to actually make any response to the sounds. Sometimes children who have been diagnosed with autism don't seem to respond very much to sounds and at other times may appear very sensitive to noise. By using sounds of varying loudness, we're hoping to learn more about how the brains of children with autism take in and process sounds from their environment. Once the session is over, the headphones and cap are removed from your child and you'll be led out of the quiet room. Because of the gel used, your child's hair will be a little sticky. We have a salon-style hair washing setup with fun towels and shampoos. If you'd like, we can wash your child's hair before you leave. Before you and your child go, he or she can also pick out a prize out of the toy bin. That's pretty much all there is to the ERP visit. We understand that this task may look somewhat daunting, but we want to assure you that we have a very high success rate for the ERP visit.